Hi, and welcome to another episode of Friendly Plastic TV. I'm your host, Linda Peterson of Linda Peterson Designs. And I've been receiving a lot of viewer email wanting me to go back to the basics and asking, how do you use rubber stamps to create textures in friendly plastic? So I thought that would be the perfect topic for today's episode. So are you ready to get started? Let's go! Talk a little bit about the types of rubber stamps that are available. These are actually unmounted rubber stamps, and I have a variety here. I have those that are deeply etched, and I also have those that apply more ink to the surface. What you're going to want is one that is deeply etched, because this will give you the best texture. There's also clear stamps, which are available in a variety of different patterns that also will give you a nice clean impression, and this is the one that I'm going to be using today.
We'll be adding a little bit of metallic color to the strips of friendly plastic with Lumi Air Paint. This is a metallic acrylic paint made by Jacquard. I have three different colors. I have pearl emerald green, pearl blue, and pearl violet. And then we'll be stamping in the image in black ink using Amoco's metal stamp pad. This is a heat set ink. Okay, I have three makeup sponges here loaded with my paint, and I'm simply going to daub the paint onto the surface of the plastic. I'm using a matte colored copper plastic. You can use any color you want. It doesn't have to be this color. You can use the bright gold or the matte gold. And basically all I'm doing is I'm covering the surface with the paint here, and we'll be placing this on the griddle, or if you don't have a griddle that you can set to 200 degrees, you can use your heat tool. Okay, I'm going to apply some ink to my clear stamp image. Now I will tell you that this is going to go through an ugly stage before it gets better, so don't give up. I've already tried this once. And we're going to stamp into the softened friendly plastic. This has been softened with the heat. Now, if the stamp doesn't come off the surface, that's okay. Simply allow it to cool. You can either do this by allowing it to cool on its own, or I'm going to put this in a water bath to cool. Now, once this is completely cool, you can simply peel your stamp off of the surface. Let me show you what that looks like there. Okay, I reheated the other side of the plastic and I stamped in the same image, except this time I did not use any ink. So I wanted to show you what that looks like. You can see that it's just the raised texture here, and then you can see the difference here. The side had the ink. Now, this is the plain strip of friendly plastic before I applied the paint, so you can see what this looks like, and it's a beautiful textured image as well. Now, if you want to make some of these highlighted areas, these raised areas, stand out a little bit more, you can go in with some of Amoco's Rub and Buff. It only takes a little bit on a makeup sponge, and you can just gently rub over the surface and bring out some of those raised areas. This also gives it kind of an antique, agey look. And I really think that you'll love the result of what you get. Now let's turn this into a little pendant. So I'm going to snip off the end here. And I'm really liking this texture right here. So I'm going to cut this into kind of a random asymmetrical shape. I'm going to use this one. Let's tidy this little area up right here. We need to make our hole with the hand punch. So I'm simply going to make a hole in the top and the bottom, because I want to have a little dangly. There we go. And I've also made this little coil out of wire that I hammered earlier, and we'll glue this onto the front with a little bit of silicone based glue. Let's get a little glue on our toothpick here. I use E6000 because if it runs over, it's easy to clean up. So I'm just going to lay this on the front like that. Give it a nice little highlight. I've made a little dangly that I will attach to the bottom. I like to mix my metals. Just because I use gold doesn't mean I use gold on the entire piece. This is a little silver dangly. Now on the back, if I want to make the back all pretty, I could actually put another piece of friendly plastic onto the back as well. Or I can simply paint over this with my gold leafing pen or use my Amoco Rub and Buff, which I will do later. And we're going to add a jump ring to the top, and there you've got a simple rubber stamped textured pendant.
Now while we primarily used rubber stamps to create the textures in our project, you can use anything you have laying around the house. Maybe it's a sewing machine bobbin, a grouping of paper clips, or maybe a couple of vintage buttons. You can use anything to create a texture. If you need more inspiration, be sure and check out the video by Liz Welsh. This is a DVD called Bend It, Shape It. She's a UK artist that is the queen of texture, and you will absolutely love this video. And once you create your pieces, be sure and email them to me. Email photos. We want to hear from you, and I will feature you on our blog at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com. You can also go there for more projects and more creative inspiration. Well, that'll do it for this episode of Friendly Plastic TV. I sure hope you enjoyed it, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time.